Hello everyone, this video is just about a snapshot giving you an overview about African food, especially Nigerian food. I just want to show you a different perspective, another side that you do not know already about African food. So please stay tuned and watch. This is Grace Ronke Adegoke. Talk about food and nutrition and health, especially helping people to achieve optimum health and fitness in their lives. So please thank you for watching and come back and watch all the videos that I've got lined up on my channel. Thank you. Have a good viewing of this video. Leave your comment down below. Thanks for watching.
Hello, good afternoon guys. This is me, Grace Ronke Adegoke. Welcome again to another episode of my videos. So today we are talking about Nigerian food. I could call it African food, but basically just want to touch about Nigerian food. So there is an overlap between all the African countries and the Caribbean as well in regards to the ingredients. So let's get started. First and foremost, let's start on the vegetables. So we have a long list of vegetables in Nigeria, because the sun is shining, it's raining, and also lots and lots of tropical fruit. So today I have here baby spinach and the matured spinach, and I also have for people outside of Nigeria who cannot pick your own or just go to the market next, you know, the next street and buy fresh and eat fresh, there's frozen spinach there from all over the supermarket. And also this is another vegetable, ugu, which is also very good and rich in iron. So, and also here we have okra. Okra is also a vegetable, and some things about okra I need to mention is, you can see this bowl is full of okra. We love okra in this family. I'm sure most Nigerian families will love okra too. Now, when you go to the shop, you pick up one and you go like that, snap the tip. Did you hear the snap? If it doesn't snap, that means that okra is overripe, overdone. So it's not going to cut easily. Okay, so usually throw that away or use it for another type of okra, dried okra. Okay, so because I've seen my grandmother do that years ago. So still on the subject of vegetables, there are a lot more vegetables that we can talk about, you know. So you have bitter leaf, you have efo tete, which is also called kalalu or amaranth, and you have amonu tutu, you have egorigona, you have, you know, so many green leaves in Nigeria. So, but for today, I've only brought a few samples, and there are so many different ways of cooking this. So, perhaps at some point, we have a clip of one of the recipes so you can see it. Okay, now we move on to the carbohydrates. The chief of carbohydrates in Nigeria, I think, is yam. Maybe everybody will agree with me, I don't know, but yam is something that you take to your in-laws. You know, the bigger your yam, the bigger the affluence, and they know that you will look after their girl when she marries your son. So yam is a very it's a, as you can see, it's a root vegetable, and it's a very good one that is low in glycemic index until you pound it or roast it. So that is another topic for another video. So I'm just trying to showcase what we eat, basically. Now we have cassava. Cassava is another root vegetable, like a cousin or sister to yam. And also cocoyam is here, similar, as you can see, its distinctive design on the outside. Cocoyam could be yellow, could be white and purple, and the same thing goes with the yam. And also we have sweet potato, which everybody know very well because they are widely available in all over the countries, all over the world, basically. You have them in different colors as well. Okay, and then we have, I have sweet corn here. Sweet corn is something that could be very, very versatile, you know. Like now, I bought this fresh from the shop. You can see what I'm doing now. I'm peeling off the blankets off the sweet corn. Oh, sorry, sweet corn. You put your blanket back in a minute. Okay, so that is how you peel it down. It's not difficult at all. You peel it down to expose what's inside, which is this. That's the corn. And this is as fresh as it comes from the farm. Sometimes you get sweet corns that has just been picked, and the sweetness and the succulence of such is amazing. The flavor doesn't have like a smell to it, but when you actually eat it, either boil it or roast it. And also, sweet corn, it's not just a vegetable, it's a carbohydrate as well, a starchy vegetable. So beware, but it's very good. It's got some level of protein as well. So here, so many things can be done with this, which I will talk about in a minute. Now we have plantain. Plantain is also referred to as a vegetable. Again, plantain could be vegetable / carbohydrate because of the how it responds to cooking. And if you have a look at what's in my hands, from here to here to here, different depths and different shades of color, because they are different stages of ripeness. So the more ripe your plantain, the more sugar you have in it, the more glycemic index you have in it. So you can use plantain for so many different things, which we can talk about again in another video, the benefit of it. But briefly, you can roast, you can fry, you can saute, you can barbecue, you can put plantain on the griddle, you can put it in your casserole, you can actually mash it, you can make it into a pounded jam, and which we will come into in a little bit. And also, I have coconut here. Coconut can be eaten directly when it's broken. You can drink the coconut water, which is good with in electrolytes, and also quality fat, you know, that people are talking about, that the world is raving about. Gone are the days when coconut was touted as the tropical oil, you know, with its causing palm oil. Anyway, that's another political debate another time. But coconut is good for you. So there we have it. You can use it in your cooking, put it with rice, you know, coconut rice, eat it as a snack, toast it and toasted coconuts, and you can get the oil out of it, the milk out of it. Use a lot of coconut milk in Indian curries and all over the world. So we have here another section of what we can call, this is protein / carbohydrate again. These are pulses, you know, beans, different types of beans. This is what they call oloyin beans, which is basically, it's got a little sweetness to it. That's what set it apart from other beans. I don't know, perhaps there will be more sugar in that beans compared to other ones that are not sweet. Like for instance, the black eye beans, this is canned basically. And of course, I haven't seen this variety canned, but there are so many canned pulses. But black eye beans, this yellow or brown beans, sorry, they're very, very very common in Nigeria. So it can take you a couple of hours to boil this to a very soft texture. Usually you can use pressure cooker or just put it on fire, you know, and just ignore it with plenty of water and let it boil away. Okay, so this same, this is also beans, but it's been peeled, if you like, washed, you know, and dried. So the outer coating of the beans is removed for the purpose of making moimoi. Moimoi is like a patty. I mean, completely vegetarian. It's not like liver patty, but basically what you do is you blend it together with all your your red pepper, your chili or scotch bonnet pepper, and you have something like that. That's my book, by the way, published a few years back now in Waterstone bookshops all over the country. You know, it was in Waterstone, some local bookshops. Okay, so let's put that down. There is a full recipe in there for my mom, and of course other things that we have here. And also, now we're moving to more carbohydrates. We have cassava flour, because I was saying before, you can use cassava in other things. People do actually boil cassava. They can pan it with some yam. They can eat it boiled, and also they put it into powder and you mix it like a flour. Okay, in fact, that is a gluten-free flour for those gluten-free eaters out there. All of this on this table, actually, they're all gluten-free, believe you me. Okay, so again, we have semolina, and that's another fufu or swallow that people eat in Nigeria. We also have cocoyam flour, you know, like that cocoyam into flour, like you've seen this one. Okay, and also we have maize meal. You know, if you're very familiar with Zimbabwe, Kenya, South Africans, Zambia, they eat a lot of maize meal. This is Awisa, this is a brand for the Zimbabweans. However, it's the same corn. So this corn is made into the maize meal or corn meal. So basically, again, like a flour, you see corn flour in some of these gluten-free packs or even thickeners and stuff. That is what it's about. And this is commonly eaten in the northern part of Nigeria. Actually, we eat it when I was growing up. I wasn't living in the north. You know, it's called tuwo. So out of all this, there is an array of fufu or swallow that can be made. So you have gari also, which is not on the table. I have like a 20 kilo bag. You know, I'm sure some people know what gari look like for the purpose of this filming. So you can have pounded yam, you can have fufu, you can have semolina, you can have plantain fufu, you can have cocoyam fufu, cassava fufu, you can have maize meal, which is a form of fufu as well. And also there's sweet potato there. I've got something up my sleeve to turn that into a low GI type of fufu with some high protein, gluten-free flour. Okay, so be on the lookout for that. Now we move on to these two in the front. You have some chicken, what we call hard boiled chicken. You know, basically it's got more flavor, more bite to it. You know, so in back at home, most people are self-sustaining in those days. You will have like 6 chicken in your compound, you feed them every day. Sometimes they lay eggs, pick the egg, and then you eat the chicken. Organic, free range, roaming around. You know, so what our mothers and grandmothers and aunties were doing back at home years ago, the Western culture is embracing it now, and that is the main thing. And I'm doing another video again on things like that. Okay, so we don't have enough time to talk about that part of what we eat at the moment. Now we have the oily fish mackerel. It's one of my favorite ever, and red snapper. So there are so many other variety of fishes which you can cook with a stew. You put chopped tomato together or fresh tomato with your red pepper and onions, your scotch bonnet pepper or birdseye chili. I actually prefer scotch bonnet pepper. It's got more flavor to it. I never see my grandmother cook with chili, you know, because I learned a lot of things from her. Anyway, so, and now we come to the oils that we use back at home. As I said before, coconut can be made into oil. Okay, so there is coconut oil, this gigantic one, because I use coconut in everything now. So and also we have granite oil, you know, which is also very good and it's got some flavor to it, goes nicely with the roasted yam. And also now the chief of the oil is the palm oil, you know, and this, as I said, is sustainable and also ethically sourced. You know, most palm oils from Nigeria, from Ghana, you know, because that's the way of life of people. They don't have to disturb any animals to get palm oil. So please, people, if you look on this table, look at the colors of these peppers and the palm oil. You know, this is the richest item on this table as far as antioxidant is concerned. But we've been brainwashed to think that our own product isn't good. In fact, we've been brainwashed that palm oil will push up your cholesterol. That's a lie, because this is from plants. There is no cholesterol in this. You know, oh, this is a carotino. Yes, it is carotino. That's the name from where carotene comes from. Okay, so basically, that is the antioxidant carotene inside this, inside carrots as well. The same reason why carrots makes you see in the dark, the same thing. And also, the palm oil itself, the richness of the antioxidant helps and protect your heart from cardiovascular risk and things. So please, people, let's go back to basic. And palm oil is the oil that you can actually use for anything, because it has high smoking point. It doesn't oxidate when you cook with palm oil, as opposed to some other type of oil, you know, that have been promoted. So of course, every oil has monosaturates, polyunsaturates, and also the saturated fat. So basically, what is different is the percentage in each of them. And because palm oil was deemed to have a higher percentage of saturated fat, but this is plant. I mean, so God has made it so, my people, okay? So, and now that people have embraced coconut oil, I don't see any reason why they're not embracing the palm oil yet. A few years ago, I was writing a book on the tropical oil, you know, and the political saga around it was just a political propaganda, you know, to promote some other oil, you know, some years back. Anyway, that's something, as you can see, a passion in my heart that I need to get across to people, okay? I use palm oil to cook. My cholesterol is like marked as low, okay? Guys, use that, utilize it. It's good for you. Now, we move on to something else that's on my table here. Some spices. These are like classic. Curry powder, thyme, you know, in Nigeria, or even for Nigerians, when they cook, you put a little dusting of that. And when you make jollof rice, I mean, where is jollof rice? Which is like the staple of every Niger party, or even in people's homes. So basically, when you cook that type of thing, you curry powder and thyme is a must, okay? There's jollof rice in there. And also, we have egusi here. Egusi is like pumpkin seed. You know, this is also rich in good fat. So please, don't let us ignore it. And what is important in everything I've said is moderation and your portion sizes. And of course, that's another topic for another day. And also something else I have here, you know, as part of our culture, even people, whether they're poor or rich, they like certain drinks. One of them is Supermalt. Okay, Supermalt. And nowadays, there is all kinds of juice flying around in Nigeria or even here, you know. So when you go to party, the amount of drinks on your table will depict how much money they've spent on top of the lavishness of the food. So please, people, all of these drinks, they are full of sugar, and that's what is killing us. That's what is shifting our healthy food. Like, look at this table. What is on this table that is not supposed to be healthy or that is not healthy? But when we eat them, you know, in excess, you know. So that's another topic we're going to talk about another time. So basically, let's cut down on whatever. So instead of just drinking Supermalt, Fanta, Coca-Cola, juices, even natural juice, they all have sugar. Let's go for water. This is a thirsty job. Top up of my fluid for the day. And this is something I'm doing at the moment on Instagram. H2O challenge. Are you drinking enough? Maybe get something like this, fill it up, and put it on your counter and sip it as the day goes by. So that's your fluid, and you keep drinking. You can drink other things, basically, but stay away from sugar. Anything that is sweet in your mouth, cut it down, and then invariably, eventually, you know, get rid of it. So now I was just going to mention a few food in here, or that we know that we eat, you know, typically from the vegetables. We have a furry roll or vegetable stew, and you can also use kalalu or amaranth or efo tete, as we call it back at home. You can combine it with your spinach, your ugu, and some other vegetables that are available wherever you are. I have some Caribbean dishes in here, so I'm just going to go straight to the Nigerian dishes. And of course, we have puff puff here, which is served like, you know, like a finger food, kind of like appetizer. But this can also be used as desserts. You can pair this up with some ice cream and a dusting of cinnamon. Hey, presto. And of course, you can use banana or pineapple, griddle them, you know, and serve them with some ice cream as well, or something else that you've made yourself. So what else do we have? Let me just go straight to the in here. Okay, so we have yam in here, being used to cook pepper soup. Okay, yam pepper soup. I have another dish here. It's a Caribbean Jamaican national dish. That's ackee and saltfish. And we've seen moi moi and also a furry roe vegetable. Now we have pounded yam and all kinds of swallow, an array of swallow. And this is not exhaustive. There are more, you know. Again, I was talking before about jollof rice. You can have fried rice, coconut rice, pineapple rice, all kinds. You can be creative, basically. And also we have ogbono. Ogbono has a consistency like when after you've cooked okra. It comes from a seed that is ground and used and cooked together as a one pot soup or stew that you can eat, swallow with. And there's pepper sauce. You know, pepper sauce goes with everything and anything, even your pasta, your white rice, your rice and beans, and you can put meat in it or fish or nothing and eat it as a vegan or vegetarian. And we have rice and beans or rice and peas. Rice and peas in the Caribbean and rice and beans in Nigeria. Okay, there's our jollof rice, egusi, the egusi like a pumpkin seed that I showed you. It's dry, you grind it, make it into paste and fry it up in palm oil and pepper, mixed with meat or fish and dried fish or stockfish and crayfish, and the whole house is perfumed. Okay, so that's egusi. And this is the maize meal, you know, the satsa I was talking about, made from the corn. That's the maize meal. And you can, in other parts of the world, they call it sata in the Zimbabwe, ugali in Kenya, inshima in Zambia. Okay, and they call it pap in South Africa, but very runny and like breakfast. not for lunch or dinner. And in my tribe, Yoruba, we call it tuwo. And also in the north of Nigeria, they call it tuwo masa. Masa means beans. Because they have another tuwo made from rice, which is tuwo senkafa. Okay? So don't ask me where I pick Hausa from. Kadang kadang. Okay? Right, so we have a different type of sauce, ofada sauce with ofada rice, you know, and that is typical of the Ogun State, Abeokuta people. You basically cook the ofada sauce or ayamase in the palm oil. You blanch it basically, and that, you know, this is one, if not the only oil that you can get to that smoking point. Okay, now what else do we have here? And don't be surprised if you're looking for information about oil and palm oil is not listed, because they've you know, in quote, you know, push it aside and tagged it as tropical oil that is no good for you. As I said earlier on, go and do your own research, go and dig down. I have materials if you want to know more. And we have jerk chicken here. This is Caribbean and this is akara. Akara is something that you make from the peeled beans. As I said before, you make moimoi from the same beans. Very similar process, but the consistency of the akara is slightly thicker than moimoi, so it doesn't fall apart. Imagine you're making a pancake and it's too, way too runny. It's not going to bind or stick together. That's the same principle when you make akara. It's so simple to make. You can make akara quick, especially if you have the beans already peeled and washed for you. Okay, and akara can go with anything. You can go with pap, you know, what else? You can eat it on its own if you're embarking on keto diet or paleo diet, you know. And most of these things on this table, apart from the carbohydrates, you know, you can use them, you know, in your keto journey. Okay, and some of them can be adapted to fit. And so this is puff puff made from either self-raising flour with yeast, and you let it proof like you would do a dough for bread, and you fry it up in vegetable oil. Okay, and of course you can put sugar in it, you can put spices, chili, even some put people have seen people put chili in puff puff. You can put cinnamon, nutmeg, and spice it up, you know, as you like. And this is another sweet deal, plantain. So when your plantain is this ripe, it gives you this result. When it's fried, you just cut it down, 2 minutes, flip it over on each side in a hot pan with some vegetable oil. You can serve your plantain with your rice, your beans, your ake and saltfish in the Caribbean, your pepper sauce, and fried eggs, beef, fish stew, and the list is endless. And of course, that's just one way of cooking plantain. So many other ways. So we have plantain combined with mixed beans here and some salad. That was a classic vegetarian vegan on my menu in my restaurant. So yeah, that's absolutely gorgeous. And I have here just in the back cover pounded yam and egusi, which is very traditional. They go together. Of course, you can serve pounded yam with okra when it's cooked, with ogbono, with ewedu, with eforiro, with, you know, any soup that you desire. So there are so many food items in the Nigerian diet that we have not been able to talk about today. But I hope this has opened your eyes to more, to know more about what Nigerians eat, which is very similar to what most African countries eat. And as I said before, the portion sizes, I think, are the main downfall. The Nigeria of today is different to the Nigeria of yesteryears, the one I grew up in. is slightly different as well. 50 years ago, let alone talking about my mother or my grandmother and their mothers. So thank you for watching. I hope this has been useful. If you have any question, please don't hesitate to ask. Thank you once again. It's me, Grace Ronke Adebuke. Have a wonderful, wonderful day. And whatever you do today, whatever you choose to do, make it count. Bless you. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.